Welcome to the lecture. In this video, we will cover the topic such as descriptive statistics for numeric data. In that, we have to see the sub-contents like measuring the central tendency, that is the mean, median, and mode, the standard deviation also. We have already seen the concept, but how to implement it with the help of inbuilt function in Python, that we have to see today. Then next comes the defining measures of normality, that is the skewness and kurtosis. Next is the counting for the categorical data, and then comes the understanding the frequency. So we have to see all this in terms of inbuilt function. Next we will cover the understanding of the tools, that how to restore a checkpoint, what is the restarting of the kernel, and that all. So I will cover all this topic one by one. So starting with the first one, that is the descriptive analytics. So over here, I am importing two libraries, that is the pandas as PD and numpy as NP. And if I want to check that what is the version of the pandas and the numpy library, then you can check like this, that is, if you want to check the pandas version, then you have to write the alias, that is PD, then dot, then double underscore version, and then again double underscore. Similarly, you can check the version of the numpy also with the help of version. So you can write np dot double underscore version double underscore. So if you run this code, then this both libraries get imported, and you will know what is the version of NumPy and pandas, as there are a lot of updates nowadays in such type of libraries. So which libraries you are using, so if you want to know the version, then you can write the code like this to know the version of NumPy and the pandas library. Next, over here, I am loading the loan underscore full data set. This data set I have already provided you into the drive. So this loan underscore full data set is the complete train data set of the loan. And previously that loan underscore, that is only loan.csv file, was a part of the this complete loan data set. So for the easiness, I have provided you only the some rows from that data set. Now this is the loan underscore full, that is the loan train data set. So I am loading this data set with the help of pandas library. So I am writing pd.read underscore csv, and I want to know the first few rows. So I am writing loan underscore df. So whatever my data frame is stored in my variable, that is the loan underscore df, where df is my data frame. So my data frame, and I am writing dot head function, so it will print my first few rows of the data set, and these are my different column names, or we can say the variable name are. Now we will see the topic, that is the measuring the central tendency. So we will see the topic based on this particular data set. So I have loaded this data set. So I am writing over here, that is the loan underscore df, that is my data frame name, that is over here, that where my complete data set is present. So my data frame name, that is loan underscore df dot operator, I am using an inbuilt function, that is the mean. And I want to calculate the mean of the numeric data only, not the categorical one. So this education is my categorical data, this gender is my categorical data. This effective date and due date are my data of which the type is date. So it is of data type. So wherever my numeric data are, so I am writing numeric underscore only is equals to true. So I want to calculate the mean of only the numeric data. So I can zoom it out a little bit, so you can view easily. Okay, fine. So I'm running this code. Can you can see that terms, age, and principal, these are my numeric data. So it is giving me the mean of the numeric data. If you don't want these two columns, that is the unnamed one and unnamed 0.1, then you can drop the column. So how to drop the column, we have already seen in the previous video lectures. Now I want to calculate the median of the numeric data only. So I am writing numeric underscore only is equals to true. Then you can see that it is giving me the answer and it is calculating the median of my variable, that is principal, terms and age. So these are my different values in the principal column, that is 1000, 1000, 1000 and like that. So whatever the values are in the complete data set, that complete data set will be considered, and based on that this median will be calculated, and it is showing the result like this. That is in term, that is for the column principal, I am having the median like 1000. For the column terms, I am having the median, that is 30. Similarly for the mean also. Now over here I want to calculate the standard deviation. So you have to write like this, that is loan underscore df dot standard. So it will give the standard deviation like this. Now next is, over here I want to calculate the difference between maximum value and the minimum value in each and every column. Suppose I want to know that what is the difference between maximum principal amount and the minimum principal amount in this particular principal column. Then I want that difference. Over here there are the different values for the terms like 13, 15 and so on. Then what is the difference between maximum value of the term and minimum value of the term? So I want to know that for the numeric columns. So I am writing, that is print my loan data set dot maximum. It gives my maximum value, and over here it is my minimum. It gives me the minimum value. And I am performing for the numeric data only. So I am writing numeric underscore only equals to true. And I am subtracting, that is maximum minus minimum. So it will give me the difference, that what is the difference between maximum value and minimum value. So it is giving me the answer as 700 for the principal. So let's see over here what is the minimum value for the principal. So for that I am writing loan underscore df into the square bracket. I am writing principal dot minimum. So it will give me the minimum value, and from the principal column my minimum value is 300. Now over here suppose I am writing the maximum value, that what is the maximum value in the principal column. So it is 1000. So 1000 minus 300, the answer is 700. So like this we can perform the difference between the two. Where this is useful, if I am giving you the definition, like find out from the student data set, find out the difference between the maximum score in a subject and the minimum score in a subject. So what is the difference between the highest marks and the lowest marks? So that kind of computation you can perform like this. Next comes the quantile. We have already seen that what is the quantile. It is very useful in the box plot. So over here I have used the list, that is 0, 0.5, 0.50, 0.75 and 1. So different ranges, and I am writing, that is my data frame, that is loan underscore df dot quantile like this. Then you can see that whatever the numeric columns are, it is giving me the answer like this. That is for the range in the first quantile, my all the values for the principal amount are below 900. What is your IQR? That is the range between 0.25 and 0.75. Then you can see that maximum values lies between 900 and 1000 in your principal column. There are very less values which have the values as 300. So like this you can perform the computation that in your data set, what values are maximum present in your data set. You can see that in the age column, there are very less people who are having the age as 18, and your maximum people in your data set, that is the loan underscore full data set, maximum peoples are of ages between 27 and 35, because it is in the range of first quantile and third quantile. This 18 and 51, this age of people are very less in your data set. So the people who are having the age less than 27, that are also very less people present in your loan data set. So you can perform the analysis like this by using this quantile function. Next comes the counting for the categorical data. Above we have seen that we have done the counting for the quantitative data. So it means the data is continuous. Over here now we will see about the categorical data. So the first one is understanding the frequency. So for my education column, in my education column you can see it is my categorical data, and there are different values like bachelor's, college, high school or below. So I want to know how many people are there who are having the degree as bachelor, how many people are there who have done their college, and how many people are there who has done the education like high school or below high school. So I want to count that number. So for that, what you have to do, you have to write like this your column name, that is the loan underscore data frame education column, and you are writing dot value underscore count. So like this you can count the total number of frequency. Then you can check that the people who has done the high school or below, there are 151 peoples, or we can say 151 data present in your data set. Who have done the college, the count is 149. Who have done the bachelor, the count is 44. And who has done the master or above, the count is only 2. So who are taking the loan? So maximum people who has done the high school only, or the education below the high school, such type of people are taking maximum loan. So you have done the analysis like this. Now describe function, you all know that you are writing the data frame dot describe, then it will give the complete count, that is what is the total number of rows, then what is the mean, what is the standard deviation, what is the minimum value, what is the maximum value, and you can get all these answer in a complete one function, that is the describe function. Now next comes the loading example from the online site. So suppose if there is online site, so on online site I am having my Python file, that is my pyplot underscore text dot py, and I am writing a modulo over here. So if you want to load some online examples in your Jupyter notebook, then it is the first condition is very necessary that your computer should be connected with the internet. So you can write the syntax like this, that is the modulo, then load, because you want to load the examples from the online sites. And then you have to give the URL, or we can say the link. So I'm writing modulo load space and my URL where my this .py file is present. So when I'm running this code, then you can see that my complete load has been loaded in my Jupyter notebook, that is my .py file. And when I run this cell, then you can view the output also. So see, this is my output of this my particular online example. Now obtaining the online graphics and multimedia. Again over here, it is very necessary that your computer system is connected with the internet. I am writing this, I am importing this library, that is from ipython.display import image, and I am writing embed. This is my image as the function, and as an argument I have to pass two values where my where is my this particular, that is the website name, and your address of the image, that is my folder name in uploads, and then I am having my image name as layer-hands.jpg. And again after this rounded brackets you have to again write embed over here, and I am running this code. Then you can see it gives me the image from the online website, and it is the image of hand. So like this you can perform all the analysis. I am already providing you this particular Jupyter notebook, that is .ipynb file on your drive. Now let's see the other things, that is understanding the tools. We will see we already know that how to use the Jupyter console, how to restart the kernel. So let's see how to restart the kernel. Click on the kernel and click on the restart. Sometimes it happens like your code is not functioning very well. So if there are some variables stored in your background in the cache memory and you want to delete it, then you can restart the kernel like this. So the kernel will get restarted, and if your code is malfunctioning, then it will work properly if you restart the kernel. Then next come is restoring a checkpoint. So this particular file is not saved. So suppose I am saving this file, then you can see that the checkpoint is created. Again, I am saving, then you can see over here that checkpoint is created. So if you are doing some functioning with your file, it might happen that you want to undo all the files. You want to undo all your code. So for that, you can write like this. That is the from the file menu, you can select the option that is revert to checkpoint. When you click on this, then it will provide you a dialog box that is revert to the checkpoint, and it is showing me that Tuesday, July, and this date. So you want to go back to your previous code, and that checkpoint was created on this particular date on this time. So you can revert in your code, then you can, it means what, that you can undo your changes in your code, that is in your Jupyter notebook. So like this, you can restore the checkpoint. Then comes performing multimedia and graphics interaction. We have already seen in loading examples from the online site, that also we have already seen. Into the measures of normality, there are two measures, that is the skewness and kurtosis. So skewness defines the asymmetry of the data with respect to the mean. So if the skew is negative, so the left tail is too long, so we will tell it as the left skewed. And for the positive skew, it will be in the opposite direction, that is the tail will be too long on the right hand side. Kurtosis means it shows the whether the data distribution, especially the peak and the tails, are of the right shape or not. So if the kurtosis is above zero, the distribution has marked the peak that you can see. Suppose over here I'm drawing one graph like this. Then what you can say that maximum number of your data values are present in this particular range. So if I draw, then I can say that maximum values are present in this particular range. There are very, very few values in this range, and there are very few values in this range. So if your graph of histogram, or you can say the skewness, is like this, then your maximum values lies in this. So what is this? This is the distance between first quartile and third quartile. So you can say this as the IQR, that is your interquartile range, where your maximum values are present. Very less value on this side and very less value on this side. So we are keeping it till here. Thank you all.